So today we're going to understand what is this process yield, what is the first time yield, and how it is different from the first pass yield. We'll also look at what is roll throughput yield, and we will understand all these three terms: first time yield, first pass yield, and the roll throughput yield with the help of animated examples. So please watch this video till the end. So if you are watching this video for the first time on my YouTube channel, then please make sure that you hit that subscribe button and please press that bell icon so that you are notified whenever I post a new video on my YouTube channel. So in this channel, I post videos related to Six Sigma, Lean Manufacturing, Project Management and Business Management. So let's first understand the term yield. So yield is the percentage non-defective items of all the items that are produced. It is used in manufacturing to measure the performance of a process. It is defined as the ratio of the number of non-defective items produced divided by the total items that are produced. Let's understand this with the help of some animated example here. Assuming that we have a machine for which we have 10 parts that will be processed through this machine. So once it is processed, we get 8 good parts and 2 bad parts. So your number of non-defective items will be 8 and total items that are 10. So the yield will be 8, that is your good parts or the non-defective items divided by total items that are produced is 10. So you get a yield of 0.8 or 80%. Yield are normally of three types: first time yield, also known as FTY, roll throughput yield, RTY, and first pass yield, FPY. Let us understand all these three one by one with the help of animated examples. Let's understand the term first time yield. So first time yield is defined as the number of units leaving the process as good parts, which include some of those which have been reworked, divided by the number of units put into the process. Let's understand through this example where we have 10 parts which have been processed and we get 8 good parts and 2 bad parts. So out of those 8, 2 were those parts which have been reworked and put it back as good parts. So we'll put the formula. It is number of units leaving as good parts, which includes rework, divided by total item produced. So in this case, you have number of good parts as 8, which includes 2 rework, divided by 10, that is the total item produced. So your first time yield will be 0.8 or 80%. So in this case, the first time yield takes only what went into the process and what comes out, so which includes what have been reworked as well. Now let us look at what is first pass yield. So the first pass yield is defined as the number of units leaving the process as good parts but with no rework, divided by the number of units put into the process. So first pass yield is also known as the throughput yield. Let's understand this with the help of the same example. So we have 10 parts. So we will process all these 10 parts. So we get 8 good parts and 2 rework and 2 as bad parts or rejected parts. Now the first pass yield says the number of units leaving as good parts but without rework. So in this we have 8 good parts, but out of these 8 good parts, 2 were reworked. So we'll subtract those as well. So 8, that is good part, minus 2, that is rework, divided by the total items that are produced. So we get a first pass yield as 0.6 or 60%. So that is how it is different from first time yield, where you take the consideration of rework. Now let us see what is roll throughput yield. Before that, we have just learned what is first pass yield, which is only used for individual sub processes. But if there are more than 2 processes or 3 processes or n number of processes, for that we have a rolled throughput yield. So rolled throughput yield is the probability that the process with more than one step will produce a defect free unit. It is a product of each process throughput yield or the first pass yield. It is given by process 1 throughput yield multiplied by process 2 throughput yield multiplied by process 3 throughput yield and so on, depending upon how many process you have. Let's understand this also with the example. So assuming that we have three process, process 1, 2 and 3. So we'll take those 10 parts, we'll process it through first process run. We get 8 good parts and 2 rejected parts. And out of those 8 good parts, 2 were reworked. We will calculate now the TPY or the throughput yield for process 1, which is 10 good parts or total parts minus 2 rework minus 2 rejected divided by 10. So we get 0.6 as your throughput yield for process 1. Now we take those 8 good parts from process 1 and process it through process 2. We get 0 rejected parts, 8 good parts but 1 rework. So in this case, your throughput yield for process 2 would be 8 minus 1 rework minus 0 rejected parts. So you get 7 by 8 and 0.87 as your throughput yield for process 2. Now you take these parts and process it to process 3. You get 1 rejected part and then 8 good parts, out of which 1 is reworked. So you calculate the TPY for process 3 as 8 minus 1 minus 1. So which comes up to be 0.75. So now that you have individually calculated TPY for each process, now it's the time to calculate the rolled throughput yield. The formula is given the top. So we'll put that in the formula and we'll add, multiply all these three. We get 0.6 multiplied by 0.875 multiplied by 0.75 and we get 0.39 or approximately 40%. So your rolled throughput yield for all entire process is 40%. So if you are still watching this video, please make sure you hit that subscribe button and do press that bell icon as well, and you can also watch my other videos as well. But before that, please don't forget to hit that like button as well.
Hello and welcome to yet another video series from Digital E-Learning.